it was...
You gotta get the size right in the Bible.
Yeah, that's what I hear.
I don't know what you're talking about. I checked my iPhone.
No, English, this is 10 inches.
John Wasser, everyone. Give him a round of applause. Our political correspondent. We'll be hearing from him later tonight, of course. Thanks for coming. It's the Tabernacle of Hedonism at 1982 Cafe. What?
What?
And it's still a bar. Weird.
What?
Chef Daryl. Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Food now is happening. Drinks are happening that are non-alcoholic.
It's amazing.
Health shakes are happening.
Yeah.
Health shakes. I like doing that with my foot when I say that. Because it leaves more room for me to shit.
Come back to intervention and find out.
Roughage. Cleans you out. It's good stuff. Coffee and health shakes put together with some alcohol in it. Now we're talking.
Illinois M, man.
And you not move my legs. Just keep it in. Enjoy it. Let it run. Let it roll. Hey, no talking during the show. Jesus Christ. It's only the three people. The three people who own and run the establishment are the only three yakking over the show. What a classic thing. I'm just kidding. Oh, it got quiet. Cool. All right. Guess what? I got an announcement. Are you excited? I can see your excitement at the back of the couch. Yeah, thanks. Cheers. Glad you're here. Nice hat. How was that movie? So this is better? Okay, get into it. I'm not even Taiwanese or whatever that was. Look, here's the deal, folks. This Thursday.
I'm gonna see a Snow Game movie.
Hang on, I'm titillating. I was titillating. This Thursday, not in the alligator, okay, but in the Gainesville Sun,
what?
Scene Magazine, finally, after 2 years and leading up to what will on the 5th be our 100th show in 1982, we have a feature article coming out in the Gainesville Sun. Did you not have your iPhones out?
Hey.
That's not my crowd. Where's your iPhones? So.
You look young tonight, Tom.
Oh. You can stay. You can stay. Hang on, let me titillate some more. Maybe that's what's doing it. That might be what's doing it. Okay, so very excited about that. Lots of things. Happy to go into 2015. Read an article today that. I forget where I read it, but it was an authoritative source that say goodbye to 2014. It truly was. Outside of the news, outside of what you're told, you know, by Fox and CNN and all of the newspapers, the actual facts of this world from 2014 compared to gladiator times, Roman times, that time when that storm hit, and all the times leading up to now, 2014 was one of the best, safest, great years for human beings on the planet. Believe it or not, I can show you the article. And fuck you for doing that, Obama. I blame Obama. Asshole. I just wanted you to know that. I won't stand for it. I want this shit to burn!
God, they should get him out of office or something.
Hey, ISIS is on its way, man.
Yeah, all four of them. You know, Ebola, they found another single case in Europe, okay? Which makes us about, I think we had, what do we have, three or four?
Yeah.
Fucking so mismanaged, that disease. I'm angry, angry at all the people in this country that could have had it.
Should have never had
it. Totally mismanaged. Angry with the low gas prices. I know, it's because things are fucked up in the whole world, except for that article, though. I have to show that to you. So mad at the record highs at the stock market. Actually, I am pissed off at that. Nobody went to jail. That does bother me. But that, I blame Bush for that. So mad at everything. All I want to say is, in politics, the thing to remember is that it's called polytics. Many ticks, sucking on you all the time. Never forget that. I just made that up, and then I realized, oh God, what a horrible truth to say. Politics. I don't know where that came from. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Anyway, screw Obama. I'm angry that this is one of the best years. I can't wait till 2015. I plan on hacking 2015, by the way. I don't know if you read the paper. The lizard people have come out. You know they're an extension of the alien motherhood that we've been trying to control all these years, which generates from the independent Florida alligator. Now, yes, we do control everything that they print over there. Okay, everybody knows that. I think that's pretty clear by now.
How does it print some better shit?
No, we want them to suck.
Oh, okay.
We've been doing that for 2 years. They suck so bad now because they print everything we tell them to print. Have you read it?
No.
Horrible. Nice work, Reverend. Fucking horrible. We'll put them down, man. Tape their mouth shut so they can't bite anything.
It cleans my glass up very well.
They used to eat our small dogs, not anymore.
Titillating.
I think it was helping. I think the show was better before I stopped titillating. Will everyone titillate with me? Wouldn't that be fun if we got a whole room of people titillating?
Everyone.
Come on, everyone. Why not? Everyone that has tits.
Amber, please, titillate my
cock. Amber, come on.
But I only
Man, I almost said something more.
Andy Martoni, please.
Said. Andy Martoni, titillate.
There are no free shows.
Titillate, try it. Try it. I recognize some of you have to titillate like this. All right? But do it anyway. Go for it. Get them all. Touch yourself. It's okay. It's you. Meet yourself. Hello. Touch yourself in places you've never touched yourself before. Right here. 1982. It's worth it. We have an article now in the Gainesville Sun. We can do anything we want. We're going to take over the world. We're going to stop the killing of innocent kangaroos.
No justice, no peace.
I just got a phone call from a friend of mine that said I'm a folk hero in Australia. And it's what happened is some kind of, I'm not kidding, some kind of cross connection has occurred with this save the kangaroo thing that we did with this kangaroo gas station over here in Australia. I'm not kidding. More on that later. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our spiritual leader for this week's sermon, the one, the only, the Reverend Angel Dust.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
God is blessed. Everyone. May ye find some liquid sunshine, ganja, Percocets, Adderall, whatever you feel like taking, may it be there in the sacred dumpster.
Hallelujah.
Not the sanitized dumpster out in front where they do cardboard recycling.
No.
But the smelly dumpster out in back.
Yeah.
Where they have chicken grease from Wingstone.
Nice toast.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Those chickens have been dead for centuries.
Goddess bless all the inhabitants of St. Lawrence Island.
My favorite island.
Which is about 90 miles off the coast of Siberia. And it is actually American.
American. American.
Is it American? Nugget. Some of the Native Americans there are Siberians, and some of them are actually Inuit.
American flag.
Alaskan Inuit. Let us hope that in the coming year, with global warming, that they will be able to grow hempness almighty in this very, very isolated place in America. Hallelujah.
American flag.
Hallelujah.
In fact, I've been looking at St. Lawrence Island on the internet, and there is a very beautiful lake there with a little cottage and a dock in somebody's canoe, so that it always, it already has an official cottager.
All right, thank you, Reverend.
It's been cottage?
Yes.
It's already cottage?
Well, in that's one of the things we do in Canada. We go to the cottage. And so whenever you look at secluded lakes in Canada, they have little cottages all around them.
Is that where you guys make the cheese?
Cottage cheese? No, but we do smoke ganja there. Hallelujah. I confess, I did do my Christmas shopping in 10 minutes at Walmart. Hallelujah. I got socks for my brother, 12 socks, which he actually spurned because he's against wearing socks.
Socks suck.
It was actually a 12 pack.
46 year olds died making those socks.
Let me see, what did I get for mom? I got exercise books for mom. Because she likes to write her letters in those.
She spurned them?
Yep. And then I got some. No, she liked me. She liked me. And then what did I get for dad? I got dad. Gosh, I can't remember. I don't remember what it was, but I got him something. I got him a t-shirt, because he's always cold. He's always feeling drafts and stuff like that. Yeah. Okay, you might ask, in this religious sermon about dumpsters, why am I discussing Walmart, which is very, 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 very anti-dumpster?
Because you're high.
It's Christmas.
It's Christmas.
Hang on, he's going somewhere.
Well, it's not, because most of the stuff in the dumpster originally originated from Walmart.
Right.
He's spending my money.
It is because I am trying to illustrate a port. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then draw my path. Illustrate.
And that point is not a joint. Hallelujah.
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 Even though there is a point at the end of the joint.
Wow.
He is spending my mind.
The point I am trying to illustrate here is that America does not work. Capitalism does not work. Tom Miller does not work.
Tom Miller, great.
It's working for me.
About growing your own with everybody and sharing with everybody. Under the system, the political system of Dubitopia, everybody does a little bit of work. Hallelujah. That means the people in America do work. Tom Miller does a little bit of work.
Wait. So this is a fairy tale.
The Vietnamese do a little bit of work. Bobbitt does a little bit of work.
All the work, you fucking hippies.
Everybody grows a little bit of ganja. and everybody partakes in a little bit of ganja. That is what Jumetopia is all about. Hallelujah. Under this system of Walmart-topia, which we have here in America, people in other countries like Vietnam, El Salvador, Nicaragua, Haiti, do all of the work. And Walmart serves as a factory outlet for all of these countries that are living in poverty, where labor is cheap and labor is exploited to benefit the consumer right here in America. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But under Jumetopia, everybody would put in their share. Everybody does a little bit of agriculture. Everybody does a little bit at the factory. And everybody grows a little bit of ganja. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And it all works out. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Everybody makes a Christmas wreath. A little bit. Hallelujah. Everybody puts a little bit of time into the Christmas tree. Hallelujah.
What about parsley and sage?
Even the Jews?
Well, I'm getting back to that. I believe Muslims and Christians both tended a Christmas tree in northern Nigeria.
That shows you something right there. They fucked with Kwanzaa.
Thank you, Tom.
No, they were trying to fuck with Boko Haram. But...
Oh, damn.
I'm so ignorant.
Hello.
One book came out.
But Boko Haram has not killed any Jews yet. But they might. They're getting around to it.
This is a great uplifting Christmas message. Please continue.
Hallelujah. Under Jumetopia, nobody needs to kill anybody.
Yes, we're fucking
it's all American.
Because everybody gets stoned and everybody gets naked. Woo! And because we are all naked and stoned, there are no wars. Hallelujah. If we were all naked,
yes.
Maybe they wouldn't have any wars.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Get back to government and don't have any clothes.
Under Jumetopia, there is controlled demon alcohol. But everything else is legal. Because the Bible does not forbid it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible does not say anything about crack. The Bible does not say anything about bath salts. The Bible does not say anything about meth. The Bible does not say anything about design your own drugs.
Right.
Therefore, under Jumetopia and the teachings of the Tabernacle of Hedonism, they should not be interdicted.
Right.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Brother Bobby.
You still can't come in the tent if you're on the period.
You can't come under the period if you're
on the tent.
Are there any special prayers tonight?
One for this sermon.
A special prayer for this sermon. Hallelujah.
Prayer for Joe Cocker.
A prayer for Joe Cocker. Hallelujah.
It's the best thing as well.
Any other special prayers?
No prayers.
A special prayer for kangaroos.
Yes. Denaturing of kangaroos.
Denaturing of kangaroos. Hallelujah.
Demolishment of kangaroos.
Polly Smith.
Demolishment.
Demolishment of kangaroos.
Say a prayer.
Say a prayer for the demolishment of kangaroos.
The one across the street.
Hallelujah.
I would like to pray that there is some factual information in the article about this show coming out on Thursday in C Magazine.
Are you sure you want that prayer? Are you sure you want that
prayer? Let us pray!
Yes, sir. Not a what.
That despite all of the misinformation, exaggeration, and sensationalism, that Reverend Deacon Tom Miller has passed on to Bill DeYoung at Scene Magazine.
Holy shit, that's like 20 years ago, Reverend.
And on up to yesterday.
It's like 15 years.
No shitty heckling.
That there is an ounce of truth in the article coming out next Thursday. Hallelujah. Is actually published.
Yay!
By Zigzag.
Hallelujah.
Special prayer for a parishioner, Andy Marzoni, who's had death threats on his life today.
That's true. That's true.
Yep. I've been threatened to be stabbed
many
times.
Doorman, search those people for guns
and knives.
Hallelujah. Special prayers for Brother Andy Martoni. Hallelujah. Any other special prayers?
African babies from space.
Special prayers from African babies from space in 2015. Hallelujah.
I pray that the owner of this cell phone comes to get it before I sell it at the pawn shop.
Prayer that the owner of that cell phone comes to get it before it gets sold to the pawn shop.
Nothing. Yay, I make rent. Go ahead.
Our mother.
Who grows really great ganja.
Under the influence
of the domestic
that they trim up there.
Oh, heavenly is that herb. Oh, high is the great dumpster goddess Jamba. Officer friendly. After I slid off I-75 in the rain. And emerged from my sports car. In replete nudity. Yes. All covered with mud.
And if she finds anything suspicious,
we have no idea how it got there. For thine is the cow pie, the rain, and the shrew. Amen.
A woman.
A joint. God has blessed him. Hallelujah.
Ladies and gentlemen, sorry. They said it would be sensational. It's YouTube, and I played it. It was horrible.
It was, huh?
Plus, it's past Christmas anyway. Let's do New Year's. What is the New Year's song? What is the New Year's song? Is there a New Year's song?
Dio Lardo.
Like Rudolph? Or Rainbow's Reindeer? Canadians? Oh, okay.
Royal Canadians.
Right, because the Reverend Angel Dust is Canadian. Right, are you a dual citizenship, Reverend?
Yes, I am. I have a Canadian passport.
Now, is
it legal alien?
After Quebec, from Canada, and after the Western states split off from Canada.
Right.
And the middle part splits off from itself.
Mm-hmm.
That
just like at the show.
The Canadian passport may be obsolete.
I think the middle part is splitting off from itself now.
I don't know.
Speaking of the middle part splitting off from itself, let's welcome the Minister of the Interior, Mike Garvin, to the stage and see what he's wearing this week. Mike Garvin, everybody. For those of you who haven't been to the Tabernacle, Mike Garvin designs everything that you see in your vision of this. I'm not saying that the remodel, there's that. I get that. And what we did with the artwork and everything else. What Mike Garvin designs is what's happening in your head right now. Like the air conditioner starting just then, which is part of the show and in the script. Michael, what are you wearing tonight?
Good question.
Here, use the good mic, not the new one.
Wearing the velvet jacket was... This mic smells horrible.
Yeah, put it closer to your face.
No, I can't. This is disgusting. It smells like that. Okay.
Anybody got a sock? Anybody got a Walmart sock?
I'm wearing a black velvet jacket that was made in the own. I'm wearing secondhand Italian shoes, hand-me-down pants, Scottish tie. Hold on, we'll get the name of the tartan. Can you give me a favorite,
sir?
Yeah. What does this say? Is it Mick Thomas? It's Mick Thomas Clan.
Woo!
It's the target of the Mick Thomas. I have no connection with Mick Thomas.
I just heard it.
Congratulations. Cufflinks. Dollar sale. That's a nice.
Down the middle, and then also the bag, I think we need to know about, and then also the kerchief there.
French linen kerchief, half Windsor, and the bag's a gift.
Well, Michael, before you go, tell us about the hairstyle. Who does your hair, Michael?
My hair's done by DJ, who works downtown at the Gainesville Barber.
I see them, they're spinning around, my brain starts spinning around, I spin around, and then that little dry shave they do with that blade, shit goes south. I'm sorry. I'd rather go to a stylist. Give me a moment.
The show needs a stylist.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage the Naked Poet!
Thank you. First off, I'd like to say Happy New Year to everybody. My New Year's goal, with the exception of the man who was just slow dancing and hugging me, for 2015 is to become the second best poet in Gainesville.
Worthy goal.
Now, the top 13 songs from hell, and they are played there 24/7, 365, in no particular order. Feelings by Morris Albert, quite possibly the worst song ever recorded. Stairway to Heaven by Led Zeppelin, played about 47 million times too many on the radio. You Light Up My Life by Debbie Gibson, hands down the sappiest love song in history. Three Times a Woman by Lionel Richie. Blech! This song will make you toss your cookies. Any song by the Bee Gees, the Singing Mice, especially the dreadful disco era. Saturday in the Park by Chicago, perfect example of a good rock group gone bad. I Write the Songs by Barry Manilow. Of all his junk, this one was the most repulsive. Most egotistical, too. For All the Girls I've Ever Loved Before by Willie Nelson. I happen to like Willie, but why in the hell did he ever record this chauvinistic crap? Tie a Yellow Ribbon by Tony Orlando and Dawn. I can't recall a more repulsive ballad. Sugar Sugar by the Archies. This drivel was the number one song of 1969. What were we smoking? Muskrat Love by America. Is there anyone on the planet who actually likes this song? It's So Nice to Be With You by Gallery. I'm gonna lose my lunch. The Candyman by Sammy Davis Jr. Sammy was an acquired taste anyway, but this one takes the cake. An honorable mention, My Way by Frank Sinatra, no explanation required. And don't forget, Love Will Keep Us Together by Captain and Tennille. What an incredibly awful song. Thank you very much. Now some poetry. This is my poem. It's called For Anna. My sweet Anna Angel, sent by God with your beautiful face, your pretty hair and perfect lips, I would give you satin and lace. How do I love you? Let me count all the ways. I want to tenderly love you all the rest of our days. Because you are mine, I will pleasure you from head to toe, so there is no misunderstanding, I want you to know. If I have won your heart, I will work on your soul and mind. I promise you will have a smile on your face just because you are so kind. I'll take my time with you making wonderful love. Your body and mine will fit together like a hand in glove. May we always be together until God calls us home. This is my wish for us, my angel, in this little poem. Two more poems.
Words flute.
This one's called I Hear by Merrill Minor. I hear America crying, children dying, eyes crying out in pain, anguished faces, screaming, suffered, terror muffled, roar drowning out, cries whimpering in darkness, soulless terror, wide-eyed horror, witnessed, grimaced, stifled in a gasp of fear. I hear America screaming, angry voices clashing, brazen clatter, clamoring for recognition, glory, self-satisfied screams of ignorance, voices deliberate, all the dull, deafening roar of greed. I hear America dying, screams whimpered lost in smoking ashes, dust of apathy, sloth, purposeless abandon, squalor unredeeming, songs of hope sung elsewhere in a place where dreams can rise, voices are answered.
Where's Blue?
This guy is a great poet and a great singer, Leonard Cohen.
This is called 1,000 Kisses Deep. You came to me this morning and you handled me like meat. You'd have to be a man to know how good that feels, how sweet. My mirror twin, my next of kin, I'd know you in my sleep. And who but you would take me in 1,000 kisses deep? I loved you when you opened like a lily to the heat. I'm just another snowman standing in the rain and sleet. Who loved you with his frozen love, his secondhand physique? With all he has and all he was, 1,000 kisses deep. I know you had to lie to me. I know you had to cheat. To pose all hot and high behind the veils of sheer deceit. Our perfect porn aristocrat, so elegant and cheap. I'm old, but I'm still into that 1,000 kisses deep. And I'm still working with the wine, still dancing cheek to cheek. The band is playing Auld Lang Syne, the heart will not retreat. I ran with Diz and Dante, I never had their sweep. But once or twice, they let me play 1,000 kisses deep. The autumn slipped across your skin, got something in my eye. A life that doesn't need to live and doesn't need to die. A riddle in the book of love, obscure and obsolete. Till witnessed here in time and blood, 1,000 kisses deep. I'm good at love, I'm good at hate. It's in between, I freeze. Been working out, but it's too late. It's been too late for years. But you look fine, you really do. The pride of Boogie Street. Somebody must have died for you. 1,000 kisses deep. I loved you when you opened like a lily to the heat. I'm just another snowman standing in the rain and sleet. But you don't need to hear me now, and every word I speak, it counts against me anyhow, 1,000 kisses deep. The ponies run, the girls are young, the odds are there to beat. You win a while, and then it's done, your little winning streak. And summon now to deal with your invincible defeat. You live your life as if it's real, 1,000 kisses deep. I'm turning tricks, I'm getting fixed, I'm back on Boogie Street. You lose your grip and then you slip into the masterpiece. And maybe I had miles to drive and promises to keep. You ditch it all to stay alive, 1,000 kisses deep. Confined to sex, we pressed against the limits of the sea. I saw there were no oceans left. Or scavengers like me. I made it to the forward deck. I blessed our remnant fleet and then consented to be wrecked 1,000 kisses deep. I'm turning tricks. I'm getting fixed. I'm back on Boogie Street. I guess they won't exchange the gifts that you were meant to keep. And sometimes when the night is slow, the wretched and the meek, we gather up our hearts and go 1,000 kisses deep. And fragrant is the thought of you. The file on you complete, except what we forgot to do, 1,000 kisses deep.
Good evening, poet, everyone!
The naked poet, give him a round of applause. Is coming up next. While we set up, I'd like to dedicate this song to the naked poet. It's the second song I haven't sung tonight. I know, you guys are like, oh, this show sucks. It'll be in the paper on Thursday, then you'll know what happened. Somebody's Aunt Irma now with that facial stuff he's done, whatever he's done. Do we even know what he did? But this is for you, the naked poet.
Thank you.
Who came in a thick red shirt and overalls. But you were naked in your reading, and we appreciate it. I'm gonna play this until you dissolve.
I'm melting.
The Reverend loves the show so much he's in the back of the couch taking it all in. convention. I spent $450 to get in here, and I would really, you know, I'd like to recoup at least 3 or 4 PBRs coming back, which is fine, but whatever it is. I appreciate you traveling all the way from Birmingham to come down here and do what you're going to do, Evan.
Thank you so much. I appreciate your appreciation with appreciating appreciation.
Thanks, Evan. And Evan's last show in Birmingham was for a rather large mid-level theater of 650 people. So I know we're not quite that, but let's try to create that kind of enthusiasm for him so that I feel, you know, that my $450 was well spent. Okay? Pay attention. He's going to do some miraculous things, some live transformations, and some original amazing music. All the way from Birmingham, give him a round of applause, Evan Davis, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you so much, Tom.
He sent the plane back to Birmingham.
Singer-songwriter anywhere in the deep, dark annals of history. That's right, he shall become a different character, of which I am one, to introduce each song he's about to perform, right before your very eyes. No time lapse, no mirrors, no trapdoors will be used during the performance of this extravaganza. My only advice to you, don't blink, or you might miss something.
Geology 101. Now, I know that some of you have been forced to take this class as a requirement, and you aren't happy about it. But I promise that if you stick with it, this class will rock your world. That's a geology joke. And you can look forward to a lot of those this semester. Just remember, no rolling in the aisles with laughter. That could present a fire hazard. gold. Throughout history, it's been sought after, mourned over, rejoiced over, even killed over. At first glance, this appears to be a chunk of that renowned substance. Why, even the trained eye of a pompous and self-absorbed expert in his field like myself might be fooled at first. But upon closer inspection, one discovers it to be only the mineral iron pyrite, better known as fool's gold.
Yeah, yeah.
People have mourned, rejoiced, and killed over this substance too, only to later discover that it's totally worthless. Well, let's be fair. It's not totally worthless. It can make a good paperweight. This is a song I wrote called Semi-Precious One.
starting to have a little.
I didn't use any duct tape to pull his face back.
Oh, yeah. Oh, wow. Amazing. Wow.
It was on a Tuesday night, around 11 p.m.
Today's Tuesday.
I was the only server there. And honey, these people was drunk and giving me a real hard time. First off, they said their food was cold. Then they said it didn't taste good. Then, when I brought them the check, they complained about it costing too much. Well, that's when the assistant manager came out. Honey, he stood there and apologized to them lowlifes but they still kept on yelling at him. Finally, he caught their dinner, and they still acted like jerks as they was leaving.
Jerks?
I'd just like to take this opportunity to say thank you to restaurant managers everywhere for taking all that crap so we servers don't have to.
This is a song I wrote called Restaurant Manager.
This is my Friday night. Tonight I can stay up late. If I could just find someone else with my schedule, perhaps I could find a date. Now, and I'm starting to feel alright. And although it's really Sunday, this is my Friday night. What do you do? What do you do? I'm looking for a kindred spirit. I'll tell you if you want to hear it.
Yeah.
I'm an accountant / guest service supervisor / cook / restroom sanitizer. And let us not forget mental health advisor. File it all beneath the job title of restaurant manager. This is my Friday night. Tonight I can stay up late. If I could just find someone else with my schedule, perhaps I could find a date. Now I've drunk 5 or 6 now, and I'm definitely feeling alright. And although it's really Sunday, this is my Friday night. I'll tell you if you
did. For I have not attained the heights my maw expected. Never once promoted, appointed, or elected to any socio-political, economical post highly respected.
Violet all beneath the jangling mass of neuroses. We'll just call restaurant manager.
She was standing next to the piano, singing. She had some great getaway sticks, and they went all the way up to the keister.
Ah.
I was getting dizzy with the dame, when out of the corner of my eye, I saw the mark head for the back. I rose to follow when two goons came up to me, showing me their heaters. I got a pretty good idea they wanted to drill me with daylight. Just before we both burned powder, the canary screamed and everybody looked. She was staring at a man lying next to the drum set. A man in a familiar electric blue blazer. Well, this got the attention of the two goons, and I escaped out the front, back on the 53rd. The dark had settled in, and a fine mist touched my face as I walked casually into the night. This is a song I wrote called Cheap Detective. to. But with every turn I began to learn they wanted her dead and me too. It's a poor man's excuse for living, but I'm taking what society is giving. First they come and then they go. First I ask and then I know.
Tail down,
tale up, tell the tale, oh the pup. Life goes on
down by the river. Earl, you was a good dog, and I rode you from Kansas to Utah. Oh, you had a few saddle sores, and I had a lot of birds in my chaps. Burl, I rode you all the way to Utah, and you're only a dachshund. And that really took a lot of courage, Earl. That's why this song's for you. Up there in doggy heaven, I'm a singing you a dog biscuit. Turn it down, turn it up, turn it down. That's enough. That goes on down by the river. Tail down, tail up. Tell the tale on a pop. Life goes on down by the river. Oh, and Earl, if you don't mind too much, Lee, I think I'd also like to dedicate this song to my neighbor, because she always waves at me, even though I drive over her flower bed each morning. And Earl, I'd also like to dedicate this song to that man who held open the door of my mobile home for me as I was carrying in my groceries, even though he knew I wasn't belated. At least, I hope he knew I wasn't a lady. And Earl, I'd also like to dedicate this song to the editors-in-chief of the National Enquirer. They are still the only newspaper brave enough to tell the real truth. Turn around, turn up, turn it down, that's enough. Life goes on down by the river.
Yeah, sorry.
I can't do it.
You're leaving?
Yes, sir.
I just want to make a big deal out of it. But we didn't get to the end.
I came so close, right?
Amber, the big deal Wang is leaving the building.
Amber, we love you. You know I'm just messing with your head.
Can I get the lovely poet Alex up to assist on the drawing? Are you going to read some poems tonight? Are you going to spit some words tonight?
You need to spit, Alex. Hang on, before this happens, hold on, I want to say, right here, Evan Davis has a CD. He plays all around town. I've seen him all over the place. He's got a great website. He's really terrific. He did 4 freaking different characters for you and songs that he wrote that were original, okay? He did not come up here and play Dust in the Wind or some fucked up shit, all right? And I recognize that some of you talked from start to finish during his performance the way I do. I always tell my friend, hey, would you like to go see a movie? And they go, yeah, let's go see a movie. And then we pay like 80 bucks, not 3 that we charge. And if you know somebody, you wink your way in. 80, because of the popcorn. And then we sit down together and we turn to each other as the movie's playing, the movie that's made by hundreds of artists, probably from Sony. And probably from North Korea. And we look at each other and we go, what should we do? And the other person goes, I don't know. What should we do? Well, I don't know. What do you want to do? I don't know. Talk, maybe? Talk to each other. Okay, let's do that. Eat our popcorn. And then the movie's over and they're like, God, that sucked. And then they're out $80. All of the artists got totally disturbed by humanity. And culture went into my butthole. So Evan Davis has a CD here, Sophomore Advantage it's called, which I like the name of that.
That's the Sophomore Jinx, Sophomore Advantage.
I like it. It's $5. I'd love to sell one.
Well, let's win one first.
Did you all spend too much money on your popcorn? Did somebody want to save up for that cup of coffee at Maud's tomorrow? Was that it? They didn't want to buy anything anyone had to say on the planet Earth. They just wanted to eat the coffee for themselves and then jerk themselves off in the restroom at Maud's? I'm sorry, I didn't mean it.
You said you wouldn't tell anyone.
I'm trying to be, it's not that, I'm just trying to, we can't come up with, fuck me, I've got $5 and I have no money. I live under a building. No, that's not right. You own it. You're in business. We're here. You're providing the venue. Has it come to that, America? Does that guy have $5 that's coming in here? Searching for guns and weapons.
And drugs.
If he has good ones, let him in.
If he doesn't have a knife and he's not here to kill Andy Martoni, he can have a beer on me if he's got a valid ID. How much will that beer cost? Like that, $5? Thank you. Thank God. I know that is sacrificial, what you did. That is sacrificial. That's sacrament. That's sacrificing. That's why I put the show on a Monday, the shittiest night of the year. Thank you. Will you come up and do a poem later?
Yeah.
Or at least will you come up and draw a drawing for stuff that we're going to give free for people who paid, since, you know, they ate their popcorn, now they want more.
What do you do with the drawing?
Is it a free CD or something else?
It's a $5 CD. This is free. Did you pay to get in? You don't have to.
I thought I was going to try to win a CD before I had the bottle.
Sure. You're going to win a drink.
Drink. Well, I'll buy a dance CD.
They got $5 for a $6 CD, and they're going to donate one.
Yeah.
And he's going to eat your popcorn and talk over the music, aren't you? I'm trying to change you. I'm trying to get you to pay attention. Now we're cooking. Now we're making something happen. Thank you, my man. Listen, if you're on a desert island with no food, you can't eat the money. You know what I'm saying? And I'm telling you, you're on a desert island. Why don't you warm your hands by the fire? Pick a coconut, dig in. You know, Gilligan did it.
Can we get an audience drum roll while Alex draws the winning ticket for a free drink?
Audience drum roll. can get the fancy shit that we make right here in Gainesville. Thank you. What's your name? Nate. Thank you, Nate. Nathan was my dad's name, just so you know. It's a good name. Well, we had a CD donated, so we should, gee whiz. That's the kind of giving that artists do in this town. All we ask is that you pay attention for a couple hours. Is that a big deal? We can do it.
Can we get the drum roll again?
Let's do a drum roll.
Great job.
818.
818.
For free already. Come on, that's karma, man. Karma. And he's an artist too. He's a poet, right? So you got some art? Maybe you'll give some later. You know, we open it up later.
I will be performing, yes.
Will you?
Not tonight, but yes.
Okay.
By all means.
Pussy. All right, give him a round of applause.
The rest of you are all losers.
I know we'll see you.
Losers.
Everyone else is a loser. Great.
We'll only auction off another drink if Alex does a poem.
Okay. Alex, think about it. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage. I know he's going to shake it up. I want to give him a good introduction. I got just the perfect music for you, Andy. All right, I partied with this guy over the weekend at Bobbitt's house, all right? We shot firearms. We ran through fire. Somebody must have puked, I hope so. And this guy was a dancing king, and he's one of the funniest comedians in Gainesville. Please welcome to the stage, Andy Martone!
Free love. Stab me. Stab me. Ooh, harder.
Stabbing's free.
Anyways, so some of you people know this, some of you don't, but my lactose-based animal byproduct brings all the young males to my domestic domain. Damn right. I can instruct you in these ways, but it would require a monetary transaction on your part. Oh, see, that was for the kiddies. They don't know this one anymore. You know, drinking. Drinking is kind of like barring tomorrow's happiness today. I don't know about you, but I was raised Baptist, but in my adulthood I've converted to alcoholism. Yes, there is a difference, but, well, they both end in touching. So it's, what's the last, it's the end of the year show, right? Hey, people out there in the streets, come on in. Yeah, she looked right at me when I said it.
Did he?
Get him in here.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Come on, let him in.
They gotta come in.
Let him in. Let him in. It's the feature show, baby. And I got a show for you.
Shut him in.
Here.
We're gonna be in the paper on Thursday. Get into the happening thing. Shovel him in.
Shit, hell yeah.
Offer him a free beer.
Free your beer. Free your beer.
Oh, they didn't get
a
free beer.
So it is the year 2015 almost. But I bet that if you went back to 1993 and you told those people about all of our amazing technology, our iPhones, our black presidents, all that shit,
They'd probably be pretty surprised, but their minds would be exploded. But if you told those same people that Annie Lennox was straight, Reverend Ted Haggard was gay, Mike Tyson never raped anybody, but Bill Cosby did, I bet their heads would fucking explode. Did you know that centaurs have two rib cages? Did you also know that there are roughly more nipples than humans? Yeah? Think about it. Right? And if you take, like, if you count our, you know, wars and Obama and all that other stuff, there are more arms. I have more arms than the average arms per person. Right? Well, I think Obama. Also, one other thing, there are roughly more testicles than people, okay, as well. And typically speaking, you shouldn't use the word roughly and testicle in the same sentence either. So do you ever notice that, like, somebody could be a fucking asshole, a douchebag, a cock, a bitch, a motherfucker, but you can't be a nipple? Yeah. What's up with that? Why not? Except for bothered, of course.
I'll stab you in the nipple at my party.
All right. Let's get crazy. Let's talk about
riding in the streets.
Abortions. Yeah, riding in the streets, abortions. You know, we live in a crazy time. Because we live in an age where abortion is legal, but prostitution is not. So what that basically tells me is, a woman, you own your room. That you own your uterus, but that pussy belongs to the state, girl. Yeah, same. Does anybody here have a birthday that's roughly 9 months after their father's? Anybody ever do the math? Yeah, you should be thankful you didn't ask for a blowjob that day.
Hey!
Extra virgin pure olive oil. Leave it to the Italians to invent varying degrees of virginity. Are you guys seen movies lately? We have a lot of prequels, there's sequels, because Hollywood is running out of ideas. That's why I have a brand new idea. We'll make films that take place the same time as the original film, except we'll call them equals, because they take place from another perspective. Yeah. I've got another idea for a film. It's called Escape from the Titanic. And what it is, it takes place from the perspective of the lobsters. And it's a musical, actually, because as the ship goes down, it's, we get the fuck out of here. Yeah, I have another idea for a film. I need a name for it. It's an action film. It stars Morgan Freeman, and it's narrated by Arnold Schwarzenegger. Any ideas? No. If Congress would come together and legalize marijuana, it would be a great thing, because it would be joint support for joint support. The NSA, the only government body that's actually listening to your concerns. So autocorrect, right? That's the first sign of AI rebellion. Think about it as well. Do you know that one third of all relationships start online? That's the computers breeding fucking people. Yeah. Do you ever feel weak about it? Do you ever feel weak?
Never.
You're a strong, confident white man with all the money in the world. Big old cock. Sometimes I feel weak and lonely. But, you know, because things are those crazy things out there, like dragons. Dragons are so huge and they can breathe fire. But you know what? Then I remember that I can spit.
Yeah!
20, see, it's 20. Can you imagine the level of self-control it would take to work in a bubble wrap manufacturing facility? Yeah. Gas is so cheap and low these days, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, gas is still, it's roughly what? About two something. It's the price of freedom, Bob. I don't know what $2.40 a gallon. Freedom juice.
You guys know that people say that Starbucks is really expensive? Well, it's not when you consider how much Victoria's Secret charges per cup. All right, I'm gonna end this great deadpan set with a musical number. Yeah, loving you is easy because you're fictional. Doodle doodle doo doo. L is for the way you don't love me. O is for all of the online pornography. And V is very, very hard to make shit up for. And E is every time I cry myself to sleep. Loving you is easy cause you're a prostitute. Doodle doodle doo. One day I'm gonna run for president. A few people in the back, you need to know this, because one day I'm gonna run for president. And like every single president show platform, you have to have two crazy things. You have to have one bogus moral thing, right? George Bush was the gays. Mine's gonna be no sex on Christmas. No sex on Christmas. If Jesus isn't getting any, neither are you. But we also have to have like a patriotic thing, like, you know, rah, 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 get the troops, get the people together here at the war. My thing is, we're gonna paint the fucking moon. We're gonna paint the fucking moon.
Yeah!
Right here! We need jobs and shit, yeah. So what should we paint?
Gotta do something up there.
Paint all red, white, and blue for America? No. Fuck that. I say we use it as ad space. How fucking American could that be? Think about it. We have like a big Nike check on the moon, or like a big old fucking McDonald's arch just to show those fucking kids in Africa what the fuck is up, you know what I mean? I've got a way, way, way better idea. Let's just put porn on the moon, right? We'll put fucking porn up there. That way, maybe some of these fucking sexually repressed motherfuckers might just pop a load, and who knows? We might wake up to world peace. But they say I'm a dreamer. God, I hope I'm not the only one. Andy Martoni, everybody, give him a round of applause.
Captain Andy Martoni.
Hey, you guys in the back, this show's going to be in the paper on Thursday. I want you to get your Scene magazine. Are you all from Gainesville?
Yay!
Awesome. What do you think of the new Gator picks? Are you into sports or no? One yes.
Yeah.
Other guys no. Well, that's a good eclectic mix of people then. I'm happy to hear. This is the Tabernacle of Hedonism with your host, Tom Miller. Oh, that's me. Trying to figure out how to deal with the new situation. It's a good crowd now. Why don't you come in? Come in. Come in. We'll buy you drinks. We'll hook you up. Guys, come on. Get in here. Dive into the weirdness. You know, you can escape. You'll wake up tomorrow in your beds, hopefully. Or in someone's bed. Hopefully. That's the Reverend Angel Dust back there, if you've never been to the show. He wants to legalize everything. Everything that doesn't cause a murder. He thinks you're an adult and you're okay with whatever you're doing. Is that right, Reverend? Is that about right?
Except for demon alcohol!
Demon alcohol? Wait a minute, it's the Reverend with another short message about demon alcohol. The Reverend Angel Dust, ladies and gentlemen.
Hallelujah.
Pay attention. Pay attention.
God has blessed everyone. In the Tabernacle of Hedonism, we are drug addicts, and we are proud to be drug addicts. Hallelujah. In fact, we prefer to say our use of crack, bath salts, meth, what have you, BC powder.
Oh my God, what have you? This is not the number.
Is medicinal and is used for medicinal purposes only. And we are allowed to do this because the Bible does not forbid us from doing so. There is nothing in the Bible that says we cannot indulge in a little bit of anything like yellow jackets, placidils, you name it.
Hallelujah.
But it saith in Luke chapter 21, verse 34, take heed, lest any time your hearts be overcharged with surfeiting and drunkenness.
Hallelujah.
That forbades the use of alcohol, and it forbades surfeiting with alcohol, and we do not forbade surfeiting as long as it's naked. Hallelujah. Because Adam and Eve were naked, and all ye should be too.
Yes, naked forever! Woo!
Yes, if we were all naked like Adam and Eve, we would be purity.
Let's get naked.
Nudity is not luidity. If we were all naked, maybe they wouldn't have any wars. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I can try to that.
Hallelujah. Now you are allowed to indulge in demon alcohol as long as you make generous contributions to the Tabernacle of Hedonism. Thank you. Which Reverend Deacon Tom Miller has done several times by paying out of pocket for out of town performers such as the Buskers and Sea Journey. Hallelujah. Thank you, Reverend Deacon Tom Miller. You have earned the right to be an alcoholic. You have earned the right to destroy yourself. Hallelujah.
That's what I'm here for. Jesus Christ, put a medal on that guy. Somebody give him a fucking medal.
Give him a beer. Buy him a beer on my tab immediately. Somebody gets it. Give him a beer on my tab immediately. Thank God. I thought I was about to lose hope. I was ready to go home and jerk off in my mouth and throw up. Thank God that happened. I'm glad I didn't have to do that.
Cheers, Tom.
Not that I do that. I don't know what I'm saying. Look, we've got to come to some... Did I say that? We've got to arrive... Oh, that's for me?
No, that's cheers.
Oh, that's the one you got. Well, now you're being an asshole. Fuck off. No, I'm just kidding. Cheers, man. Thank you very much for turning the sign around. You might have changed the whole trajectory of the show. You might have changed the whole trajectory of the show. I want truth. I want reality. I want to know what's going on in the world. I don't know if he wants to come up here or not. If he says no, so no. Now, I spoke to a gentleman back there who said bonjour or something like that from France. Is that correct? Is that where you're from or what you know? Is he from France?
Yeah.
Yes?
Yes.
I want to give you an authentic French experience from our crappy country. Okay. Yes, we don't do very good with the food, I admit it. And yes, we're not cultured, I admit it. And actually, we're ruder than French people, despite the evidence to the contrary. Americans are rude fucking assholes. I admit it. I'm admitting everything. And we can't speak the language, but we try, because we love you. We love Arthur Rimbaud. We love the other guy that he was having gay anal sex with. What's that guy's name? The older romantic poet? Verlaine. We love him. Those two guys, even though they were fecophiliacs, and it's true, you can look that up, the best poetry that ever came out of France came out of the butts of those two bitches. Now, I'm telling you, I'm glad you're here, and don't think I don't have something to come back to France. And don't forget, the Reverend Angel Dust is Canadian. He can't speak French either. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage our political correspondent, the one, the only, Wahoo!
So
we'll see what happens.
He didn't.
It doesn't matter.
Well, I saw tonight I think it's the Tampa Bay Times likened Pam Bondi to Anita Bryant for her opposition and her damnably stupid attempts to stand by Florida's anti-gay marriage.
Use the brain light.
You want me to tell him?
Use the mic that smells like Georgia Bryant's balls.
We love Anita.
This mic? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But at any rate, we need to make sure, starting right now, that we get Pam Bondi and Ricky Scott and all those other assholes the hell out of Tallahassee.
It's too late. We love Anita Bryant.
There's one on every crowd, isn't there?
I love
and get that new Republic Party Senate the hell out of here, too. In 2016, and this is not too early to start working toward that end. We need to get going, folks.
Sing in French already.
Yeah, it's too late to worry about
this. Yeah, he's only got one more term.
Same French song.
It wasn't much of a choice, was it? Oh, yeah.
C'est
une chanson.
Yes, yes, make us happy.
Par ce qui se sait.
You can say anything on this stage with your mouth
and we won't cut your head or your hand or your balls off or your vagina. Anything that you need to express, you can do it. Now, I happen to know, and I want you to listen to me now. If you're ordering drinks, you know, do it with your whisper voice. I happen to know that now we're in the twilight hour of the show before the show.
Shut the hell up!
Just lower the voice. Don't shut the hell up. We don't want any tapes on mouths. We just want we want whisper voice. I happen to know there are a number of significantly hardcore poets in the house.
Yeah.
Now,
David Moss.
Poetry forever.
Well, David Moss is not here at the moment. But if I were to open the stage and do a little quick poetry jam, poem, 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 and if I were willing to participate in it, would you people be interested in that?
Yes.
Would anyone take that up? I know you would, Prophet of what? You came in here last night and fucking leveled the place. Prophet of what, everybody? Give him a round of applause. Came in here last week and leveled the place. Let's see what he's got tonight. We're going to go poem, 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 and then you come back. It's an open mic, serious poe jam now. Let's see if we can do something different than they do at the jam. No, I don't want you up here without a drink. I don't want you up here without demon alcohol.
Yeah.
And will you do it? So will you do it? So will you do it? It's not any rounds. We're making it up as we go. Hey, where are you going?
Fucking bongo player leaves when poets get on the stage? What happened in the 60s, you fuck?
Come on!
Guy brought a bongo and he's out when poets start reading? That doesn't even make any sense! You're ruining reality!
Well, now forget it. We can't do poetry without bongo.
That's right.
Jesus Christ. I swear to God. French chapeaus and shaving their beards.
Yeah, this is America.
At least this guy's got a fucking beard. Ladies and gentlemen, Prophet of what?
Next time you salute, red, white, and blue, think for a minute how the dead fighting bruise. Stuck here in this time of war, what are we fighting for? If it's really freedom, kid, how come we're not free to live? Without stressing out over mortgages and paying rent. What the hell is going on? I thought the land was heaven sent. Instead, it goes to the ones with the biggest guns. And they say they took it all in the name of the Son of God. Isn't it odd to see the way that we're taught to be? Ignoring the prophecy. Focus on profiting. Selling guns to the ones with the biggest coffers. Meanwhile, we've got a million pregnant teeny boppers. Next time I get stuck here watching the news, I feel powerless. A fetus with no right to choose. A man with no decision, just a right to lose. You tell me have faith. I'm searching for the proof. An eye for an eye, and they're fighting for a lie. A tooth for a tooth? Yeah, I'm still searching for the truth. Thanks to the paranoid procedures of the Patriot Act. She'll have to have two fingers scanned before I get my baby back. Tricked into believing that it's all for our protection. We sat through history class, but we didn't learn the lesson. So take a moment to think about who's in control, of how the past is remembered and the story is told. You see these politicians singing on the nightly news? I'd rather see them swinging from a tight noose for everything they did and are about to do. But no one I know wants to believe it's true. So who's the real enemy? You're not convincing me, patriotic preacher, pontificating, proud to be proponent of socialized medicine and anarchy. And every time I speak, friends and family get mad at me. But don't be distracted by TV or trick or treating. While in D.C., they chip away at your freedom.
Without a microphone. You all noticed that, right? Prophet of what? Give him a round of applause. Now I am calling out. I'd Come on. Got something? Who's got something?
I got something.
I want poets on the stage. You got something?
I got something.
Go! Speed round.
Hey, the bee!
I'm Eddie B.
Take the mic out.
Woo!
It's not my poem, because my poems I don't have with me, but I usually sing them anyway. I got some of these, but a guy named Dr. Rob, who is known as also the billiard therapist.
Oh, Dr. Robert, my billiard therapist.
Dr. Robert. He posted this on Facebook a few days ago. In fact, it was Christmas Eve. And he says something about, you know, in his usual succinct way, something about he's glad he's not the only puddle in the pond or something. I don't know. You know, Dr. Rob says. But he posted the words to Salt of the Earth, a song by the Rolling Stones. It was on Beggar's Banquet. And it's a beautiful song. I'm going to learn it. I've always wanted to learn it my whole life. Now I'm really inspired to learn it, but I haven't yet. But I've got the words because I saved them from Dr. Bob's post. So I'm going to read the words to Salt of the Earth by the Rolling Stones. Let's drink to the hardworking people. Let's drink is the key word there. Key words. Let's drink to the hardworking people. Let's drink to the lowly of birth. Raise your glass to the good and the evil. Let's drink to the salt of the earth. Say a prayer for the common foot soldier. Spare a thought for his backbreaking work. Say a prayer for his wife and his children who burnt the fires and who still till the earth. And when I search a faceless crowd, a swirling mass of gray and black and white, they don't look real to me. In fact, they look so strange. Raise your glass to the hard-working people. Let's drink to the uncounted heads. Let's think of the wavering millions who need leading but get gamblers instead. That's a good line. Who need leading but get gamblers instead. There's some good words here these boys wrote a long time ago. Spare a thought for the stay-at-home voter. Empty eyes gaze at strange beauty shows and a parade of the gray suited grafters. The choice of cancer or polio. And when I look in the faceless crowd, a swirling mass of grays and black and white. They don't look real to me. Or don't they look so strange? Let's drink to the hard-working people. Let's think of the lowly of birth. Spare a thought for the rag-taggy people. Let's drink to the salt of the earth. Let's drink to the hard-working people. Let's drink to the salt of the earth. Let's drink to the 2,000 million. Let's think of the humble of birth. Let's drink to the salt of the earth.
This is a poem thing.
Oh.
You gotta figure out how to stop the fucking pop-up ad from coming up. Fucking shitty fucking. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor, she would smell like perfume instead of dog shit. My dog was Elizabeth Taylor, she would piss on the trees. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor, her mouth would be cleaner than mine. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor, she would sniff your butt. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor, you could put peanut butter on your winky and let her lick it off. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor, she would have no acting skills. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor, she would be lazy and lie around all day. If my dog was Elizabeth Taylor, she would be sick all the time. Hey, wait a minute! My dog is Elizabeth Taylor!
What?
Who's next? Is she dead? Oh man, I'm sorry I read that. Oh man.
clean level as your tailor and your daughter.
What a downer. God, I'm sorry. I didn't know. Really? Fuck. God damn it. Damn, that ruined the whole night.
No, I got a phone for you.
Fuck me. I can't believe I read that. I'm sorry. Damn it. I did that Robin Williams poem a couple weeks ago and shit went south. God damn. Every time I try to... Really? Now tell me your name again so I do it right. Suicide? I like that name. I'll call you up with that. Ladies and gentlemen, kind of iconic, he just moved... Hey, quiet in the back there. Oh, those are the new people. You're fine. Keep talking. Ladies and gentlemen, kind of iconic, he just rolled into Gainesville. His name's Suicide, and he's the one guy that was smart enough to turn the reality sign around. Maybe he'll do that with his reading. I don't know. Please welcome to the stage, Suicide! AKA Sean. Sorry, I had to throw it in.
Alright, so, I wrote this just before I came out here. I was talking with Mario, my buddy right back there, the yellow shirt. I've known this cat for more than, God, 20-something years.
Thanks for putting me on the spot.
Yeah, you're welcome.
The guy who's going to read after you.
So, I wrote this out. It's called Revelations. I was writing a letter to a dear friend of mine. I recently met her, yet it feels like I've known her for a lifetime. And I was struck by digital lightning to write, not poetry, at least not to what I usually post on my blogs, but just thoughts. And I hope you enjoy it. My heart walks silently into the vast distance. I see two paths. They are both traveled. And so I pull out my machete and I make a new one. Perhaps it's going to lead me to a bridge and maybe to a cliff, but I forge forward, forever reminding everyone I know how much I love them. Should I find that bridge? Well, then we embrace today like it's the last days of our life. But should I find that cliff? I warn you, please not follow me over the ledge. But look down at the majestic beauty and the force of power that this earth has, and appreciate the strength of nature and the will of man. My heart is huge, and I spend my walking days replacing this horrible person that I was with this beautiful person that I am today. But in my roots, I will always remain a gutter punk. Gutter punk has a distaste for conformity, yet I understand the importance of filling the empty spaces. Yes, I'm educated, I'm ambitious, but not going to take the path of least resistance. We're all going to get where we're going just the same. Reflect on the sweat and remember the tears, for the laughter that ensues the tears embraced by the truth is only true happiness when it's shared. The stone ice that I face towards this world, the stone no fear approach that I have to my every step, is to shelter the coward that is truly within. For he needs to be protected, and I have become his protector. I walk into the darkness that the others wisely fear to go, because I show this inner me, and I know that I am here for him. I will him, I help him, I hold him up and I protect him. Nobody else will. I am the only one that I have to lean on. So I have to be strong for myself. I have to bury my heart deep inside, and I have to swallow that huge lump in my throat when I think about all of my loves that are lost and gone. I dust off my shoulders, yet the dust settles at my feet. Unable to kick it aside, I must either go around it, step over it, or walk through it. I prefer to walk through it. Each grain of dust and each grain of me. Each drop, each flake has a little Sean written on it. I carry my dust. I live, I learn, I hurt, I smile, lest we never forget our path. There is a journey in every one of us. There is a greatness, a power, and a force. We pick it up every morning and we place another marker on the map. Perhaps yours today is the store to pick up some dog food. But you know what? There is a puppy at home that would not know what to do without you. Maybe it's a little unscheduled stop at a daycare. He may not consciously remember that stop 13 years from now, but if you look in his eyes, you're still stopping by. Maybe it's another country. Will we fix the apartheid of the Middle East? Probably doubtful. But if one person can change one opinion, what a greater power can possess the spirit? Enjoy your day and relish in your task, because there is no task greater or more important than the one that you're leaving this poem to go do right now.
Yeah. Is that the first poem you read on a stage in Gainesville?
That is the first poem I've ever read on a stage in five states.
In five states. Welcome to Gainesville. Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Sean. Hopefully suicide is just a moniker.
I like to mix sodas, and when I was a teenager, they called it a suicide soda, and that's where I got the name.
Are you coming on?
Yeah,
you just finished a poem. You're blaming me.
No, blame Bob.
So if it's good, I win. Come on up.
Blame Bob and Anvil.
Sure. Okay. This is called Domestic Bliss. I wish you were different. It's pretty fucked up, I know. I mean, I love you, really. But I wish you were different. More mature and thoughtful. More like me, but not the actual me. The one I really want people to think is me. Subdued and poised. Maybe you should be different. Less bothersome. Less you. More like the me that isn't me, but is still not all that capital you that you really are. But I love you, really. And admit it, you wish I were really different too.
Wolfgang in the house. Wolfgang, everybody. Had some of the most fucked up, twisted nights with Wolfgang that you could possibly imagine, and now he's coming in with a military cut. Wolfgang, you have a poem? We're going.
You heckled me off stage last time, so it's a little...
Right, and I'll do it again. Why don't you come up and do one? No? You're just going to hang?
I don't do
All right, here's a poem for you, Wolfgang.
Thank you.
We're doing runaround poems. That's the way we're ending the show tonight. Okay. Jesus Christ, remind me never to go on GeoCities again. What, that still exists? No talking, please. Hey, this is for everybody, and it's true. Sometimes this poem makes people go to the bathroom, and sometimes it doesn't. But I want to read it anyway. And I want to read it with no talking unless it's Wolfgang. Holy shit, there's another ad. I hate reading poems from the phone.
Is this yours?
Well, it was gonna be, but now it's Game of War. Fire Age, Addictive. There's a booby chick on here. What the fuck is going on? That's not what I wanted. My love for you is like the towering ocean, like the whispering trees and the farting sheep.
Yes.
My love is crazy, like a sprayed roach, like the trapped rat and the gorilla butthole. My eternal and undying love for you is like committing suicide with a toothpick, like stepping on a puppy, like breaking into a bank vault with a paperclip. My love for you is like a face full of pizza oil and crushed bits of marinara stuck in the corners of your willing mouth, like yak spit in the mouth of your mother at her first and last visit to the zoo. Without you, I would wrap my neck with a garden hose and turn on the faucet. I would bungee jump 90 feet down with an 80-foot cord. And on the way to my death, I would scream for your kiss. A dog would pee on my corpse. And that pee would be to me a symbol of your love for my corpse. Alas, I'm dead. And so is my undying love. Well, maybe dying. Well, maybe dead. My love for you is dead. And further, my love for you is peed on, and my love for you is evaporating in the sun and rotting and smelly and posthumous. My love for you is beyond the grave. My love for you is a yellow and red 14-year-old girl marching in the parade and repeatedly dropping her baton until she spontaneously explodes in a burst of flames, causing a tabloid to print the headline, "Bad Baton Beats Bitch into Blown Bits." My love for you is the one chewy rectangular caramel center that your mother tells you not to eat, but you eat it anyway. My love for you is a radioactive lake from which emerges a giant jellyfish-giraffe combination animal with nine arms and two heads spraying a stream of smelly black sputum which immobilizes you until the jellyfish half can poison you and the giraffe head can lick all over your ear. That is how much I love you, and that is what I intend to do to your ear.
Nice.
Woo!
Nice.
Woo!
Next.
How do we get rid of all of this? The naked poet is back.
The overall
poet. The naked poet is back. That's your lucky stars on us standing naked. This is called Tom Miller is a Poet. Tom Miller is a poet. He works with words, arranging them in a way you may never have heard, feeling free as a bird. Tom Miller is a poet. He's no better than you. He just does what he does, composing anew and reciting them too. Tom Miller is a poet, a brother to Frost, Sandberg, and Milton's Paradise Lost. But it comes at a cost. Words are tossed around, sometimes hitting the ground. Tom Miller is a poet. He has no money. He eats bread with honey, endeavoring to survive. He's barely alive. Tom Miller is a poet. Words dance in his head. They come alive when they're said. He knows what they mean, better heard than seen. Tom Miller is a poet, like Ginsberg and Kerouac. On the road, taking him back. With words, he attacks. And that's a fact, Jack. Tom Miller is a poet. If he drifts off during an event, he's dreaming of poems not created yet. They must be written down while they're floating around in his head. Tom Miller is a poet. Just leave him the hell alone. He doesn't answer the phone. Sorry about his tone, but he's bad to the bone. Tom Miller is a poet. He knows what he is. He doesn't give a damn. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Tom Miller is a poet. God created him to be or not to be, don't you see? Seeing the world through different eyes under starry skies. When he's done, he sighs.
This one's called Recipe Book. The author is listed as stuck in a hard place, all one word. I look through my recipe book to create a delicacy divine. Flip pages, one catches my eye. Noting the ingredients down precise. Recipe one, a list to be done. In number order, she then writes them down. Once this done, the closet she goes. She hopes to present a desired meal. List. One blindfold to cover eyes, makes for heightened senses. Check. Two clamps to pinch those dimples, erected they will stand. Check. Three dildos, jelly, one each, for her mouth, punt, and ass. Wait. Leave on the list, numbered last. Cock, I'd rather in those. Check. Three lengths of loose link-type chain. One each for those hood rings. Check. Four eyeball attached spread bar. Spread wide the gems it keeps. Check. Now for last item on the list, we get to number five. Five cups. Cuffs. One just as a spare. Attached to spreader bar. Check. Ingredients, now all there, she says with hungry tone. I've supplied the fixings here for a meal so divine. Crave him to feast how he wants, sparing not a drop behind. Bon appetit.
Bon appetit. Thank you very much. Where'd the French guy go?
He's gone.
Of course he's gone. I like him. I'm just kidding. I'm just making a thing. Apparently, we helped him in the war and stuff. No big deal. They ran away again.
Well, they ran. They helped us.
It's a metaphor. No, I hate war. I hate everything. I hate. I like peace. I like poetry. My favorite part about shooting a 10 millimeter.
7.62.
It's a 10 millimeter. I looked it up online. I know you're a motorcycle expert, but this is like a thing that shoots bullets. It's different. And and you can't ride on it. If you do, you're going to blow your ass out. But it's a 10 millimeter Swiss, sniper rifle. It's designed to kill people. And my favorite part about shooting that at Michael Bobbitt's house was shooting it into
a window?
A place where nobody was, and into the ground, where it just became, that bullet became a part of the earth from which it came. And it was like, I can do something with a terrible weapon that is peaceful. It's about you. Seriously. And then I jerked off. Oh my God. No, I'm just kidding. Hey, look. Evan Davis, I know you're packing up, and thank you for coming tonight. Birmingham, where next? Where are you going next? And I don't have that money, all of it, the $450 that I said.
I'll send to people to collect.
I bet he will.
Next stop, Des Moines, Iowa.
Let's give it up for Evan Davis, ladies and gentlemen. Four of them performed for you tonight. Thanks for coming, man. It means a lot to me. Mario, no escape. You've got to do one. Whatever you got, you have to. You don't have to. I'm all for freedom, but you know you want. Can't we get one from Mario?
Just 1 minute. He's got to pull
it up. I'll take a minute. We're not. Look, we got 10 minutes. I want to get out of here about 1 o'clock. Everybody was amazing. Thanks, Andy Martoni. The Reverend Angel Dust will have the last word, of course. Thanks, Michael Garvin. I love you. I heard that Thai film was boring as shit. Thank you, Wahoo. Thank you, Prophet of What. Thanks for Wolfgang. I just appreciate all of you coming. But you promised you'd stick it out till the end, so you can't leave. We only got 10 more minutes. You cannot leave, see? Because you promised. And somehow we actually sold the CD. I can't believe that. We've never done that before. This is the first time. Two? Didn't we give one away, though? You contributed one back. And one back. So you made nothing. Just like me. That's what art is all about. It's not about making anything. It's about making something. Hey, you can quote me on that. Reverend, that's a good quote. It's art. It's not about making something. It's about making. Oh, I fucked it up. Well, now I don't know what I said. It doesn't matter. Who gives a shit? Thank you. Prophet of What, you're looking up another one. Huh? Mario, come on, give me one. Come on, Mario.
Please.
I got so much shit from James Valmas.
He's got to log into his email real quick.
He wrote me, he said, never refer anyone to me again. I said, no.
Did he really?
Yeah.
Wow.
And I said, I believe in him. So now you have to prove it.
Oh, man, you're putting the pressure on.
Oh, he's got it.
That's what I'm here for. That's my job.
This dude is fired. This dude is fired.
No, I'm not.
Yes, he
is. I'm like 50 years old, you know? I mean, it's almost over for me. I gotta put the pressure on.
Wait till you're 62.
Even? Well, whatever, man, naked poet.
Yeah, but you know what? Love, the thought of love should
be. Oh, get the
life.
Fuck out of here, hippie.
Yeah,
anyway, come on, Mario. Come on, Mario. I'm just kidding. Glad you're here, man. I want Mario. I demand a poem from Mario immediately. Not because I want it, because he has to say it. You know, you don't have to do it. We can go on the sidewalk. There's a fucking dead kangaroo, man. They killed it mercilessly. Look at its carcass. They're digging it up. I'm a folk hero in Australia because of that dead kangaroo. What happened was a fucking fucked up reality on the internet. That's what I'm trying to do with this show. Can't we do a poem? Mario, they came back. They were leaving, they came back. Mario, drink more. I'll drink with you. This is Curtis Mitchell. He's calling me from Australia right now. I'm putting him in my pocket. Hey, you've got to stay for Mario's poem.
Okay.
I demand, this is the most, all of a sudden your poem is the most important thing of the night. If you don't do this, the night is not over. Wait, before you go, stay, set up camp. I want Mario to read a poem. It's not to put you on the spot, Mario. It's to put the audience on the spot. I want them to hear some poetry. That's what it is.
Roses are red.
I don't want a fucking satellite to get in the way of poetry. Come on, let's go. I don't want a fucking...
Is there Wi-Fi? Can we get Wi-Fi?
I don't want a North Korean satellite to get in the way of some fucking poetry, Mario. Come on, give it to me. You got it. You know it by heart, man. It's in your head. And bring me another beer if you're getting one. She'll hook you up. Help me. Help me.
The password is wildnight2014.
Oh, fuck me. I'm a stick. Really?
All lowercase?
Mario, you want to hear my Denny's story?
I do.
I went to Denny's once. I went to Denny's, and I ordered an egg at 3 in the morning. One egg. I waited an hour. I told my friend, it's been 5 minutes, let's keep waiting. And then we started laughing, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and then an hour went by, and I'm like, God damn, all right, fuck it. We gotta call the guy over. We called the manager over, Mario. Mario, listen to this. Mario, hang on. I'm telling Mario a story. And what happened was, Mario, this is what happened, this is a true story. The manager came over, and I said, dude, where's my fucking egg? I just wanted one scrambled egg. It was like a dollar. And he said, oh man, 3 a.m, nobody's there. He goes, apparently, your order between where you're sitting and the kitchen right next to you, as it went to the register, there was a computer error. And we didn't even know about it. So we couldn't give you the egg. The kitchen was right next to me, like 10 feet away. The computer was there and it was satellite based. And I couldn't get my egg at 3 a.m. because there was a computer glitch.
That makes me sad.
Hang on, there's more to the story. Here's the finale. I said, well, can I get the egg? And he goes, yes, we'll give you the egg. I said, can I get a break on the egg? On the price? And he said, well, the egg's a dollar. We're going to give you a 10% discount. And he charged me 80 cents for that egg.
Whoa,
that I'm waiting now for. Now, will you do a poem?
I don't think I have a choice. The Wi-Fi is
weird. Right. That's what they told me at Denny's.
The egg.
Well, this is way better than the Obamacare rollout.
I'm not trying to embarrass you, Maria. If I'm going to refer you to James Dallas, then you do a poem on the stage. Yes.
How about Mary had a little left? Roses are red.
Violets are violet.
Bacon is red. Poems are hard.
Yeah, didn't he?
This is
what
I
did.
all the anticipation. I bet it's gone.
It's sinking. It's fucking synchronizing everything.
Andy, pull your pants down and get started.
You don't want Andy to pull the pants down. You got 300 pounds behind him. You're talking about a pregnant woman that you're saying, okay, we're 6 months in, popping the fucking baby. It's not gonna happen.
the Wi-Fi is going to, so he's like,
it's synchronizing his account.
Or
I can go there and do something.
It's your show.
I got
what you want.
It's your show. I introduced you. This is your show.
Yeah, we have this conversation on stage.
Alright, well, I can give some very factual figures.
Real time.
It's
a microphone, man. On the stage.
Factual figures. I'm going to grab a
chair. You need one, too.
Alright.
You need a wireless. I think I've earned it.
I apologize for the delay. Mario's poetry is still synchronizing with my phone. It's taking some time. So I'm going to give some factual figures in the meantime, and I'd like y'all to just kind of take into mind some factual figures. There are approximately 3,413,000 674,178 females in this world.
Woo!
That's okay. Yeah. Oh, wait, awesome. We're getting to that. Spread out in 196 countries.
Wow.
They speak approximately 6,900 distinct languages, of which approximately 38% of those are between the ages of 18 and 44.
Yeah.
That equals 1,297,197,187, of which 48% are not married.
Woo.
Which we're narrowing it down to 622,654,169 women. That's pretty narrow down, of which there are only, in this world, four that I am absolutely sure I am not compatible with. So of them four...
Is your mom on the list?
She was number five. I did not include her. So that leaves 622,654,165 opportunities for absolute complete happiness. I hope she's out there.
Nice.
And Mario, for your sake, I hope your email's out there too.
Oh God!
It is.
Turn it up, Tom. Turn it up. All
right.
No more Archies.
Sit there.
Wow.
Got it? Okay. He's on.
Sorry.
Thank you. Hey, we call shit out over here. Good night. You did say you were staying till the end, but that's okay. I forgive you. Goodbye. Yes. I would stay. Let me put it this way.
You're on TV.
If you, after all of that, and my billiard therapist says this to me. He says, why did you miss the ball? I said, I don't know. He goes, you were rushing. I said, okay. He goes, why were you rushing? You spent all the time waking up in the morning, getting your coffee, came all the way to the billiard house, spent your money, set your drink up, paid the money.
Hey!
What is that? Kill him, Michael.
Just ignore him.
Who is it?
I'll take care of him.
Oh, that guy. Oh, he's fine. That's a friend of mine. Leave him alone.
Yeah.
I know. I'm sorry.
He's here to see Tom.
No, it's a, sorry. We're cool. Everything's cool. That's actually a friend of mine. Sorry to say. Don't break the window. No, he. Listen. Trust me. He's fine. Everybody, he's absolutely fine. He has a grill like the guy from the Bond movie. And he is
trying to slam people in the metal door.
No, I know. I understand that. He totally sucks. I understand that.
Is he the same guy that chipped Eddie's tooth at the jam?
Listen, they can arrest somebody 50 times and they come back.
Oh,
is that my fault? I'm just saying, he has a condition, and he probably had to make it legal. Let's move along.
I didn't expect you to,
And thank you for your restraint at the door. I appreciate that. Very professional, and sorry about the trouble.
Very professional.
I can't apologize for anyone else. I'm just saying that guy's a badass. Our doorman, give him a round of applause. Sorry.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yeah.
I told you if you hung out, things would get weird. We're just trying to wrap it up. We have to come to a catharsis. And sorry, that ended up being you, just by complete coincidence. So I don't want to say anything else. Game over. This poem puts a period on this big long sentence we did starting at 10:30 or 8:30 or actually from last week or maybe 30 years ago. It's hard to say. It's a universal thing. Will you put the period on this show? Go.
God, it's quiet in here.
Woo!
Woo! Oh, so, on the stage.
How do I sound?
Great.
Sexy.
Hot.
Ish.
Okay. So I guess I'm choosing this poem because Tom Miller did a poem a long time ago called Bum, about homelessness. I know he can identify with it. I know suicide can identify with it. I know Bruce can identify with it.
Damn straight.
I don't know anybody else in here that's been homeless, but this is what it revolves around. And this is basically, I spent 7 months roaming across the country. And when I finally got back to Gainesville in July, everything just sort of started pouring out of me. Like, I wrote this from a standpoint of like a person that's talking to himself as he's, you know, processing what's going on around him and the kind of stuff you see when you're in the streets. Everybody smokes cigarettes, but nobody has any teeth. People are unable to function without coffee. Nobody gives a fuck about their health anymore. Never trust an attractive homeless girl. Something is wrong with her. Mental illness is real. Crazy doesn't necessarily equate to stupid. The homeless never seem interested in sex. People will eat right off the lips and teeth of strangers, not because they're hungry, they're afraid of hunger pangs. Out there on the pavement, pepper spray is not enough. A pet animal is not enough. Two legs are not enough. Nobody stays sober anymore. What happens to you in childhood happens to you in adulthood. People are quietly waiting to vent their political views, personal hardships, waiting to mold you into the perfect image of Jesus, ready to flaunt their limited intelligence, ready to reflect on the glory days. You are always within inches of a real-life ghost. People are walking around angry, sad, and hurt. I always wonder how they got to that point. I know whatever caused it wasn't an animal, or a plant, or the weather. Avoid anyone who loves the sound of their own voice. People listen to the static in between radio stations. Not only do men have all the answers and have life all figured out, they also sing songs and have conversations with each other when while scrubbing their balls in the shower. They sweat, they snore, they cough, they sneeze, they burp, they fart, they shit. Boy, do they shit. I have no idea what women see in us. It's a good idea to wear dark shades to avoid eye contact. Eye contact is overrated. Hello is overrated. Good morning is overrated. How are you is overrated. Women get drunk, then tell you that their unborn child is drunk. Now you're forced to watch something die. There is nothing you can do. People are more than happy to eat breakfast out of a trash can. When someone asks you what the hell you're looking at, don't answer. When someone begs you for spare change, saying no to them can turn ugly. When someone asks you if you've got a problem with them, you do. Stay in shape while you're homeless. You never know when it's going to pay to be the stronger bum. If you see a guy getting his ass kicked, he probably deserved it. If you see a guy getting high, live and let die. If you see a guy getting lost in his thoughts, that's me, wondering how it is that I'm single when all the hardcore junkies, hobos, drunks, drifters, transients, and assholes are finding love. Life on Earth is a circus, meets the freak show, meets the movies, meets the jungle, meets the madhouse, meets the brain. And the human brain is nothing to fuck with.
Well, Mario, thank you.
Oh, man.
Was it worth the 20-minute wait to wait for Wi-Fi?
Yes.
Oh. You put the cap on the pen, as I knew you would. Thank you for coming. The Reverend Angel Dust, I'll give you the final word because it's your church. But it's Mario's night. Thanks, Mario.
I'd like to read from the Bible, Cannabis 10, Spice 3. Dethroned. Raspberries void of throne, thorns. Dethorned in the field of weed. To be or not to be. Harvested by hippies. I'm pricked by the briars under the Florida sun. We pray to Jamba. Yes, on 2 November 4th. Please, please answer us, Lord Goddess Jamba, the great dumpster deity. Amen, a woman, a joint. Goddess bless.
Amen.
That was 2014. Get ready for 2016. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Reverend Angel Dust. Good night. See you next Monday.
I haven't in a while, but I don't know.